You can represent a blockchain as a set of nodes. The nodes are all connected to one another and constantly talking so that they stay up to date. Nodes store, share, and preserve the blockchain. You could say that a blockchain exists on nodes. Nodes represents the participants on a network and they serve specific purposes. Nodes can come and go, and it's pretty straightforward about how to set up and run nodes. Some blockchains like Bitcoin have thousands of nodes online at the same time. Generally speaking, anyone can run a node if they like. So at any given time, with participants in the network running nodes, there can be millions of copies of the blockchain online. There are, however, many different types of nodes that represent a blockchain. So let me break down the popular nodes that a blockchain network runs. There are full nodes, which fully validate transactions and blocks. They keep a complete copy of blockchain transaction history from the beginning of time. Full nodes usually accept transactions and blocks from other full nodes, validating those transactions and blocks, and then relay that information to other full nodes. This requires a lot of bandwidth and computer power, but helps to keep the network running. This requires a lot of bandwidth and computer power, and it also requires gigabytes or even terabytes of data to keep the network running. Full nodes store the blockchain in a redundant way so that if one node goes away, there are copies elsewhere. So this creates resiliency in the network. Most users don't need to run a full node and likely won't because of the magnitude of data full nodes hold. Some nodes act as miners and are working to create new blocks as nodes on the network. And when a miner puts up a new block, it broadcasts that information to all the other nodes in the network. The other nodes then come to a consensus about whether or not to accept this new block. Then the other nodes spread the transaction history around. Note that a miner will always need to run a full node in order to be able to create a new block. Without that full history, it can't really accurately determine what proposed transactions are valid. So in that case, you could also say that a mining node is a full node. Some nodes will only verify recent transactions, which is a lot better on memory and storage space. Simplified payment verification is one of those types of nodes that keeps track of recent history. SPV, Simplified Payment Verification for short, is what validates your transactions on the network by providing confirmations and ensuring that your transaction is put into a block. It does not check any other transactions in the block. So everyone on the network who wants to just use blockchain should have an SPV wallet node. And when you sign up for a wallet client, that is essentially what node represents that and your identity on the network. At a high level, when a node comes up, it does a DNS, a domain name system query, and then finds other nodes. So this process continues on and on. This is an active dynamic ecosystem that works together with nodes coming and going. Nodes can be offline or online and all serve different purposes where they are constantly staying in sync on the network. The nodes work together to provide trust and resiliency in the system and make up the infrastructure of a blockchain.